Hey there, Dave here, and this is one of many times I'm just going to just sit here and just ramble on things that are going on in my head. And I've been working through 2 Corinthians in the last little while, thinking specifically about how do we as Christians just ooze evangelism? How do we live this in a way that it just natural flow out of who we are without having to worry about how do I say this or what strategy do I use or project, all these kind of things. Should I just be able to live this? 2 Corinthians walks us through a bunch of those kind of word pictures. The first one is in chapter 2 where he says we are the aroma of life. You know, Christians are better known for what we're against than what we're for. We're better known for being judgmental than being loving and hypocrites. You know, if this is people's views of who we are, then we are the stink of death in those relationships, not the aroma of life. That's one picture. The next chapter talks about the radiance of God and the illustration of Moses coming down off the mountain after being with God, and his head is glowing so much that the people are with wide-eyed, open mouth staring, that he had to veil his face so to stop them staring. Should we not look different? Should we not glow after being in the presence of God? Should God's life in us, Christ in us, should that not glow and show so it's so obvious? The next chapter goes on and talks about the veils and talks about our purpose and persuasion and jars of clay and all these great word pictures depicting this. And it comes to chapter 5 and talks about reconciliation, and we should be the ministry of reconciliation. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. The old is gone, the new has come. And this is from God, who reconciled us to himself through Christ and gave us the ministry of reconciliation. That God was reconciling the world to himself in Christ, not counting men's sin against them. And he has committed to us the message of reconciliation. We are therefore Christ's ambassadors, as though God were making his appeal through us. And we implore you on Christ's behalf, be reconciled to God. 2 Corinthians chapter 5. I want to talk about that picture of the ambassador for a second. When I was in school, 1990-91, dark ages, one of my really good friends was the ambassador's daughter. Her dad was the ambassador to Spain from Nigeria. We had lots of interesting conversations about what it was like growing up in that setting and as that part of the world, but also as my dad as the ambassador. Some interesting things that she said. I remember 4 things. One, it was a big deal that the ambassador intentionally moved away from their country to live in that place. And scripture talks about us being foreigners here or aliens here. This isn't our home, and we intentionally live here as ambassadors' representatives. And in that, there's three responsibilities. Number one, if anybody has a question about your country, they come to you. You have to be trustworthy, you have to be dependable, you have to be truthful. You have to know what's going on to be able to answer questions. The second was, if somebody's going to make a rash, knee-jerk judgment call on your country or those people, they're doing it by watching you. Are we living a life worthy of that? Third thing, if that country needs to make a public statement, if somebody needs to speak on behalf of my country, it's me. All of those things relate to being an ambassador for God here, actually pretty clearly. Number one, if anybody has questions about God, about theology, about how science and nature and God's story, my story, how that all fit, if they want to know about God, we need to be truthful and honest and integrity and dependable and reliable that people can actually ask us questions and we're knowledgeable enough to be able to answer. The second thing is if people are going to make judgment calls on God, they're going to make judgment calls on Christians, on the kingdom, on the church. If they're going to decide for themselves what God is like, they're doing it by watching you and me. I said earlier, are we living a life worthy of that? That's a big responsibility. The third thing was when God needs to speak to issues, to people, to life, to problems, to all those kind of things, I am the ambassador. It is my responsibility to stand up and speak for God. Those are the things that it means to be an ambassador. We have been given the ministry of reconciliation, of reconciling the world to God. We live here intentionally to be ambassadors, to bring it. Will we? It's more than being the aroma of life. It's more than looking and acting different, like Moses' head glowing. We have a responsibility. Be an ambassador.